Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. It is Color Me Bad Lynn, back with another fragrance review. Well, the rain is all gone, the sun is shining, and the birds are chirping. And so I'm back with my review on a fragrance that you can wear after the rain is gone. This particular fragrance is from the house of Juicy Couture. This fragrance was launched in 2019, which is fairly new. And the name of this fragrance is Bye Bye Blues, The Rainbow. So let's get into it. But before we do, I want to welcome everybody back to my channel. For those that are new to my channel and don't know who I am and what this channel is about, my name is Color Me Bad Lynn. I am a licensed cosmetologist. I'm a lover of all beauty, all things beauty. So here on my channel, we will talk about and discuss fragrances, notes, how to apply fragrance, niche brands, gourmand fragrances. We'll talk a lot about ouds. We'll talk a lot about natural skincare, faith, and lots of fun. So let's get into it. Also, don't forget to like this video if you like this video. Don't forget to share this video on your Twitter, Instagram, or your Facebook channels so all of your friends and families can actually see what we're talking about as well, especially if they are fragrance lovers. This is the particular fragrance that we're talking about today. This is the bottle, if you guys can see that. I'll lift it up a little higher so you guys can see that. Isn't that bottle beautiful? Again, this fragrance is Juicy Couture, Bye Bye Blues. Here is the actual box that it came in. Absolutely gorgeous. Box is in like a teal turquoise, faded into a powdery color blue. It's blue and gold. Nothing's particularly fancy about the box. It's just the name of the fragrance in house, which is Juicy Couture. I thought it was a pretty box, so I thought I'd share that with you guys. Again, this particular fragrance was launched in 2019. This fragrance is one of many flankers in this particular line. There are fragrances in this line called Also Orange, Rah Rah Rouge, Pretty in Purple, and Palm Trees Please. I like the name of that. I haven't smelled it yet, but I love the name. It's cute. And with this particular fragrance, some of the notes that are in this actual fragrance, you're going to get your water fruits, you're going to get your lemon, you're going to get your floral notes, musmalo, driftwood, you're going to get amber. There wasn't a long list of fruits in this particular fragrance, but I am so inquisitive into finding out what the dried fruits are in this fragrance. Because sometimes it kind of helps you to kind of say, oh, okay, that's different. I'm willing to bet, though, that there is a blueberry note in here and there's apricot in this fragrance. Now, don't quote me on that because I'm not for sure on that. You know, I wasn't in on the deal of putting this fragrance together, so I don't know for sure. But I definitely get blueberry and I definitely get apricot in this particular fragrance. And some may say, well, how do you know? Well, when you eat things, you eat blueberries, you eat strawberries, you eat cantaloupe, you eat watermelon, they have a scent and a smell to them, and they also have a taste. And you well know with gourmand fragrances, as I've stated before, they are fragrances called gourmands because they are made up of scents of edible things. And this particular fragrance does have a lot of edible notes in it. More on the fruity side than anything. Which is something I normally don't go for because a lot of fruits do turn tart with my body chemistry, and that's never good. But this one, pretty nice. I'm not sure if I would wear this out of the house for like a special occasion or anything like that, but I would definitely use it, wear it around the house, you know, after a shower, maybe bedtime, possibly using it to spray down my sheets and my decorative pillows and things of that nature, okay? So again, here is the bottle. This is absolutely gorgeous. Now, I will tell you also that the first time that I tried this fragrance, which is the day I purchased it, I wanted to know what it was all about. I was curious because I have yet to use a Juicy Couture fragrance that actually lasts on me, on my skin. That's just on my skin. You may get some people out here that can use this fragrance and it'll last you for a day, two, three, four. For me, Juicy Couture normally doesn't. They have beautiful fragrances, but they normally don't last on my skin, even with layering. They just don't last. So this fragrance did a disappearing act on me when I wore it. It turned into a skin scent like 2 hours after I applied it. And I'm like, ah, we cannot be friends. If you disappear on me that quick, it's a no-go for me. I tried it again today. What made me try it again was it smells so good. Once you get rid of that, the alcohol. Now, when you first spray this fragrance, because it is an eau de toilette, it is nothing but alcohol, alcohol, alcohol when you first spray. And for me, that's a turnoff. You know, you don't want to spray alcohol on you. That's just not what we're buying. We're buying fragrances because we want to adorn ourselves with a beautiful scent, right? To make us feel better and those around us to enjoy as well, right? So with that being said, once it dried down, the first thing I got out of the spray was the water fruit. For those who don't know, is just a water fruit that is juicy, a juicy fruit, a fruit that has contained of a lot of water. And you all know, anybody that's ever been on any type of a diet plan or juice at all, you know that when you eat juice, you want to use fruits that are full of water, because that's where you're going to get your water intake from your particular food, from your food. Okay, so you can eat your water as well as drink your water. It depends on what types of fruits and vegetables you choose. Very important. With that being said, here is the cap. The cap is looks like a gold crown. Nothing written on the crown itself. Nothing spectacular. It is plastic, but it is a pretty jeweled crown, and that's what kind of attracted me to that. That and also the color of the actual fluid and bottle is absolutely gorgeous. Another thing that kind of turned me off from this fragrance is when I popped the cap, the top of the cap was silver. And I thought to myself, uh-oh, I got something old. This might not work out very well. But it didn't take away from the fragrance at all. I will say that. It doesn't take anything away from the fragrance itself. I'll hold it up so you guys can see the actual writing on the front. It has the name of the fragrance, Bye Bye Blues, Juicy Couture. And this, again, is an eau de toilette. I'm going to go ahead and spray the cap and tell you what I smell. And while that alcohol is kind of leaving, I'll kind of go over like the difference between your eau de toilettes, your eau de parfums, and your parfums. Some of your more expensive fragrance lines, your higher end houses of fragrance, will offer eau de toilette in a fragrance. They'll offer an eau de parfum in a fragrance, and they'll also offer a parfum and then also a oil. Some of your lower end fragrances will offer you an eau de toilette and maybe an eau de parfum. You'll also find that some high end fragrances don't offer eau de toilette at all. They go straight for the gusto, eau de parfum, and parfum. The differences in the fragrances can be the notes that are in the fragrance and also the oil. The higher you go, the more of an oil content and less alcohol. With an eau de toilette, you will always find the alcohol content in fragrances are extremely high. And so I typically do not use eau de toilette fragrances at all. They just don't work good for me. Now what they do, the alcohol breaks the skin open to allow the transference of the oil and the scent of the fragrance to get down in the pores so that it actually gives you some of that staying power that we look for in some of our other fragrances that are eau de parfum and parfums. That's the purpose of alcohol and fragrances and even hair products like your conditioners and deep conditioners. So if it says it has alcohol in it and someone says, oh, well, alcohol dries and breaks the hair off. It depends on the type of alcohol that is being used. And it depends on the type of a conditioning treatment that's being used. And that's a whole nother subject. Okay, so with that being said, let's go ahead and take a sniff and see exactly what it is that we get. So right off the bat, I get a synthetic-y smell, meaning that some of the notes in the fragrance aren't natural extracts of the fruits and the berries that they're using, which is okay because sometimes synthetic-y smells can turn out to be beautiful, beautiful fragrances. I do get the water fruit. I don't know what kind of water fruit they're using. I'm thinking some passion fruits, possibly apricot, maybe a blueberry, maybe honeydew melon, cantaloupe, possibly. They don't mention it, so we don't know. But it does have a lovely scent, nonetheless. I do get the lemon. Definitely get the floral. Definitely get the floral. There's also muskmallow and driftwood and amber. I didn't pick up on the amber. I didn't pick up on the driftwood. The muskmallow just a little bit, but it's always a light, faint scent, so you can barely smell the muskmallow unless it is combined with the flower of like a gardenia or a rose. Then those two compared together, or carnations, you can really, really smell the power in that fragrance. Again, this fragrance didn't last that long on me, so this isn't something that I would reach for if I'm going out for a special occasion, out to dinner, hanging out with a gentleman friend. I probably would not go for that, reach for that particular fragrance, not at all. But around the house, maybe using it for a linen spray or something like that, then I would definitely go for that. So for me, this particular fragrance wouldn't be something that I would reach for every day, even though the scent is amazing. It's really, really a pretty perfume, but it doesn't last. And so for me, if you haven't heard me say this before, if it doesn't last, it can't stay. If it leaves me, it's got to go permanently, because you can't waste your time and your money on something that's not going to stay with you. You purchase fragrances because you want them to hang out with you for a minute. And with this one, I didn't get that. So unfortunately, yeah, this one for me is a no. Again, it smells amazing. This may be nice for someone, you know, maybe for like a gym scent, maybe, like I said, around the house. You're running some errands, running to the grocery store and coming right back, or doing something, picking up the laundry, and you may just want to spray something on you that smells really good. You're coming right back home. It's no big deal. But this, for anything other than just kind of kicking it around, relaxing, chilling, at home stay, spraying it, you know, just not for longevity, just to for the enjoyment, this for me would get like a 2 on a scale of 1 to 10. It would get a 2. I really can't give this a 2 thumbs up, because it didn't last on me. So sorry, Juicy Couture. Sorry, guys who love this fragrance. Like I said, it's a beautiful fragrance. So that my opinion doesn't take anything away from its beauty, its pleasantries. It's just that for me personally, it didn't work. It didn't last. It didn't last at all. My granddaughters love it. So they can have, whenever they come over, they can get a little smell, a little spray. But as far as for me personally, it's a no for me. My opinion, right? So with that being said, I want to thank everybody for tuning in to my channel. I want to know in the comments below, do you own this fragrance? If you own this fragrance, what do you think? What are your thoughts about this fragrance? Do you like it? Does it last long on your skin? Because all fragrances work differently on different body chemistries. So where it may not work for me, it might work for somebody else and last all day long. If you have this fragrance and you like this fragrance, how do you layer it? How long did it last on you? Comment below and let me know. I'd love to hear your thoughts and your views about this particular fragrance and any other Juicy Couture fragrance that you have in your collection that work and are beautiful, and you think that based on my taste from the videos that you've seen in the past, you think that I would like. Okay, I'd love to hear from you. So I want to thank everybody for tuning in. Thank everybody for the views. They're coming in one at a time. We appreciate you guys. We thank you. We hope that you have a wonderful weekend, wonderful holiday weekend for those. Praying for those during this holiday that have a hard time. You know, some people have a hard time during Mother's Day. You know, some people have mother issues. You know, some people have lost their mother like myself. This, I'm going to be honest with you guys, this is not my favorite holiday. If I could skip this one, I would. But that's not the way life works. We can't skip over anything. We can't delete anything that happens. We have to use it for our strength so we can move forward. And for those that we've lost, to make them proud of us and to use the tools that they have given us. And that's how you show a person that you miss them and you appreciate what they've done for you. It's by taking the tools that they give us and using them to become better people than they were. With that being said, I hope everybody has a blessed and happy Friday. I mean that from the top and the bottom of my heart. Have a wonderful Friday. Enjoy your day. Enjoy your life. Tomorrow is not promised to us. So enjoy your life. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. This is Color Me Bad Lynn saying bye for now. God bless.